we're below Mendenhall Bridge. We're really on the downstream side of an area we call our measurement control. What I'm doing today is I'm putting in and mounting pressure transducers, and it's a level auger, and what it basically does is once water comes in contact with it, it samples every 15 minutes and it measures the pressure head above this sensor, and we'll convert that to a unit of feet. Top notch engineering here. We tend to put bigger bolts in. We've kind of learned over the years. These rivers like to eat things. This will just verify the top of that water surface, which is really important. We want to know that where the top of it is at every one of these points, because that defines the slope. And then what we do is we tie it to a datum. We'll tie this to a datum, which is on the bridge, which everyone works off of. And so we'll do this at several different cross sections downstream, and then we'll continue upstream. Really what we're doing is we're just measuring as much as we possibly can through the flood. And to do that, we have both mechanical systems and we also have Doppler radar systems that we put in the water. They're really good at high velocity. We can hold it from the bridge on a tethered rope. We just go back and forth and do cross sections. It's quite something, and it works really well. The channel changes. It's constantly evolving. Really, 2023 flood, it definitely blew out the walls, you could say, a little bit, and definitely cut down. It scoured deeper. We noticed it, but it really wasn't until the 2024 flood that it really redefined our upper end. I mean, we had to build a new rating. It really was a significant change. Things don't stay static in nature. And so that's why everywhere we go, every 4 to 6 weeks, we measure so that we're capturing those changes over time.